Hello, Chris Green here with the Flood Insurance Guru. Today we're talking about flood insurance for what's called builder's risk. Or let's say that you're building a new house and it may be called a builder's risk loan. And the reason for this is because the structure is not completed yet. So it has different types of coverages. You know, you might have heard of a home insurance policy called a builder's risk. So while the builder's building it and you haven't quite taken possession yet, they have to provide a certain type of coverage. So today, we want to talk about how to get flood insurance on these type of properties. You know, what coverages are available? You know, builder's risk is a big thing that we get here at the Flood Insurance Guru from different people across the country because banks will require it. Now, generally, on a builder's risk policy, contents coverage is very limited. And of course, one of the reasons for this is many times the property's not secured, maybe walls aren't up yet. So if a flood comes in, there's nothing to stop it. The other thing is business loss of use, or of course, additional living expenses won't really be needed in this situation because no one's occupied the structure yet. Now, once you take possession or maybe your client takes possession of this property, coverages on this type of policy will change. But generally, when it comes to a builder's risk flood insurance policy, the coverages that you're mainly going to be concerned about that are going to be there is what's called the dwelling coverage, which is going to cover the actual structure. Now, a lot of times what we get to is the flood zones are incorrect because they're building on a property that does not currently have a structure. And so sometimes if a bank tells you that you're in one flood zone, FEMA might say you're in another one. We always recommend reaching out to a local county or city, depending on who handles the National Flood Insurance Program for that community to verify this flood zone. We just had one last week where they were saying they were in a low-risk flood zone. Bank was saying they're in a high-risk flood zone, and they actually were in a high-risk flood zone, but it's because there wasn't a structure on the property yet. So these flood maps were off by a little bit. So if you've got questions about how to put flood insurance on a property that you're building, or maybe you're a builder and you're trying to figure out how to get the right flood insurance in place, please reach out to us, floodinsuranceguru.com. Go to our YouTube channel, make sure to subscribe there where we do our daily flood educational videos. Or you can like our Facebook page, The Flood Insurance Guru, where we do these videos as well.